Okay, working on my focal point midground tree. Lots of selection work here. Figuring out what to cut out, what to leave in. But this is the thing that's going to draw the attention, I hope, of the viewer. That kind of sells this as a fantasy landscape. So just some of these elements are going to be more of a pain to cut out than others. In this case, I get to kind of invent this edge. Decide what should be kept and what should be cut out. And I'm just using my lasso with a 1 pixel feather setting right there. And if there are any spots that are weird that I want to change, I can use that spot correction tool right on the layer. And it will help. Now, if I was actually a paid concept artist for this work, I wouldn't be wasting all this time compositing. I would just be digitally painting and simplifying this background. But if I'm doing really refined cleanup shots, this is the kind of detail and the kind of skills that are needed. Because it's all just pixels at the end of the day. The digital artist's job to figure out the best way to use them. And what's nice is I start cutting out closer to the horizon, then the composite layers I have in the background help to sell the illusion. So now the mountains are peeking through the tree. With each element I erase out. Good to save my progress as I go. And this is why, when you have a budget for something like this, you shoot your own reference and you shoot it on a green screen or in a studio. Or I've known photo shoots out in nature where you hang giant sheets behind elements like trees so they're easier to select and use. You're not always having to do this kind of stuff. But it's good to know that it's in your arsenal as a compositing artist when you need it. how many branches. The end is in sight with this little nest of them. And that one pixel feather is really helping. As I do this, I'm grateful whenever the background looks believable, right? That's less compositing I need to go back and fix in the background. So now, as I've got the canopy of the tree cut out, it's really going to help stitch together the illusion of the background with the foreground. And that's what a good middle ground focal point is supposed to do, those three layers of depth. now it's about transitioning the bottom of the tree into the landscape around it. And that's why I have the overlap I do on the ground. Because it's all organic, hopefully I can just use a soft-edged eraser to clean that up. All right, so done all the cutouts. Now I can use the direct adjustments because the tree has kind of a different lighting and color. And in a way, that's good as a focal point, but I just want to see what options there are. I can play with the levels. Do I want it brighter or do I want it darker? Play with the color balance. Right now it's in a slightly greenish light. So I can push that a little bit warmer. Not too warm. I still like how it stands out and it's very warm. Go back to color balance, I might play with the shadows instead of just the midtones. Push those a little bit cooler to go into the foreground. Yeah, that's helping. And then the highlights, I can do the opposite. I can push it a little bit warmer. And then hue saturation. So it's always levels, color balance, then hue saturation. Take the overall saturation down a little bit. Shift the hue back and forth. That makes more sense. And now I lock that layer. And move on to an extreme foreground that was easy to cut out because it was on a white background. And then play with its direct adjustments. And that covers up a lot of the things that I have to seam with. So do I want it, it's in the extreme foreground, I want to look past it, so I want it darker. And I want to limit its highlights. So that's darker. Color balance, midtones, shift it a little bit warmer. Not too much. See that texture. And then hue saturation. Shift its hue slightly. Take its saturation down a little bit. And then it's got this pesky little halo of crisp cyan. So what I'm going to do is use my magic wand with contiguous unchecked. Click on that. Let's try 32.